How's everybody tonight? Come on. Yeah. Since we're kind of on the quiet side here for a minute, before we get you going and we get us going, we're going to start with a ballad of mine that goes back a few years. This is called Pearl, and we're going to feature Dave Drewson on his acoustic piano, and this on my sort of semi-acoustic guitar. And we will get to introducing you to this, the younger half of the rhythm section. Of you.
Thank you. Ridnour on drums, and Perry Kostiach on bass. That's the younger half of the room over there. You know, we're, well, you know what. Anyway. Dave and I have been doing this a long time together, and the great thing about it is that we get to come back to places that we love. One of them is definitely Jazz Alley in Seattle. We've been here many times, and we have you be back here and have you here. And it's a, you know, we travel around quite a bit around the world, around the U.S., and as you probably know, there's not too many Jazz Alleys out there in the world, you know, so keep it going and keep it precious, and tell your friends to come and support all the great music that they have here. Of course, they've been here for many, many, many years, so what are you going to say? They're doing it right, you know. And Dave and I have been also doing it for a long time, and he a bit longer than me even. And I don't know how many film scores and television shows he has composed, but it's probably over, for sure, over 100. And you know, if you look up his credits in Wikipedia, that'll take you about a half hour to read. And you know, definitely an Academy Award winner, multi Grammy Award winner, and he started with his partner back in the day, GRP Records, which for about 20 years, every jazz artist that was probably came through Jazz Alley for sure was on that label at one point or another. So he's done a lot, and we have done a lot together. We have a brand new album that is gonna finally drop this spring. It's called Brazil. And we went to Brazil last year and recorded it with a lot of Brazilian musicians down there and singers, and really a nice project. And we'll be back hopefully with the whole crew doing something in here in Seattle, you know, summertime around then, when the record comes out. There's a track, one song on the record that I wrote that is not particularly Brazilian. It's a jazz waltz. It's called For the Palms, and it was dedicated to some palm trees that had to get moved in our house in Los Angeles to, you know, things like fires and all sorts of crazy stuff. But we saved them, and so I ended up one day writing a song for those palm trees that withstood the test of time. And we're going to play that jazz waltz for you right now. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. That tune goes back quite a few years now. It's called LA by Bike, and you know, it was one of those grooves where you're riding the bike and you get in a pattern and you start hearing this thing in your head, and I went home and wrote that tune, so it's a fun one. And makes it a little better when you have this great rhythm section with Wesley Ritenour and Eric Kostiuk. So Wes hasn't been up here yet with his own band, but one of these days he's rocking in LA at various clubs with all the A players back then, just kind of the way that I came up, and, well, Dave came up earlier, but... and Pierre Kosiewicz here on bass, he won our guitar and bass and keyboard, and he didn't win all the divisions, but he won the bass division of our Six String Theory competition that we had going for a number of years and that we are going to rev up again next year. But Pera was from Serbia and won a worldwide competition for bass. What year was that, 18? Yeah. And then in Sweden. So then he decided to make LA his home and establish himself as a player and session guy and producer and writer and all those good things, and traveling with various people, and so he moved there in 2020, and that was an interesting year to move to start a new career. So he tells the story, he was at IKEA buying a bed, and they announced on the intercom that the quarantine would be starting the next day, and he wondered, he didn't know that word at that point, and he said, quarantine, that must be some sort of big sale. I better come back to that. But he found out. Anyway, he survived that, and he survived LA, so give him a hand. I'm going to turn the mic over to Mr. Dave Grusin. He's going to say hello, and hopefully play one of his many compositions that he has for his films or TV, or make one up now for you, which he's been known to do also. Anyway, say, give your love to Dave Grusin.
Thank you, Dave. I can't remember, did we already give the speech about how great it is to have this club here? We didn't. You all are here, so you know about it, but the fact is, not many places exist in a world like this, for sure. And to be able to come to a place that's as well run as this and have an evening and hear some great music, I mean, that's there's not much better than that. So thank you for supporting this place and keep coming back, okay? Thank you. Now, I guess I'm supposed to play something. I'm trying to think of what it might be. I did a film years ago called The Heart is a Lonely Hunter. And, some ancient people here today. I remember that. It was a kind of a beautiful film, as I remember it, my memory being what it is. And I'm going to try to remember how the theme to that picture goes. It starred Alan Arkin, who we lost last year, and an incredible actor. And anyway, I don't know, that just popped into my mind. I don't have much control over that sort of thing anymore. It just happens when it happens. Anyway, here's the theme to... What was this film? The Heart is a Lonely Hunter. Okay.
probably over 100 of those beautiful themes that he's done for movies and television. And the scary thing about it is that he can remember most of them. He can't remember the titles, but he can remember the music. So, you know, some of us are getting a little further on age, and, you know, this guy doesn't forget much. So that's the good news. So we can all aspire to that. Dave and I are going to play one more ballad since we're kind of in this mellow mood, and then we'll rock out with these guys in a minute. But this is a tune called Amparo, and this was written by the great Antonio Carlos Jobim, the Brazilian writer, who, as you probably all know, wrote many, many popular tunes that crossed over in the 60s and 70s and 80s. But this was a little more of a classical nature of a piece, and Dave and I did two classical crossover records. I think the reason we, besides us being great friends and collaborators, we love so many different kinds of music, from funk to rock to Brazilian to straight ahead, jazz and classical, and of course all the movie stuff that Dave has been involved in. So we've crossed over throughout the decades with each other, and in the early 2000s we did two classical projects with orchestra. One was called Two Worlds, and the second one was called Amparo. So we don't have the orchestra here tonight, but we're going to play this tune called Amparo, and the other title is called Ola Maria. But let's see if we remember it.
Thank you. go there just for a minute, you know.
Thank you.
so much, once again, Dave Pearson, Tara Kasaya, Wesley Mayhour, that's all we did. Thank you so much for coming out. Have a great time. It's been great being here in Seattle. You guys are lucky to be here. Thank you so much. Good night.